leadership style calls, and I don't want you to think that I can't do it. There's just a secret. But what you would hear at this competition every year is something like this. And these guys do this all day until somebody passes out or they crown the world's greatest duck call. And the problem my dad had and we have is that ducks, wild ducks that come from Canada, they don't do that. If a duck is in the competition, it's the World Duck Championship, the duck not only would she not win, she would finish dead last. And so my dad said, I'm going to build a duck call that sounds like a duck. That was his thought.
Revolutionary.
And a lot of those guys said it would never work. Because they thought you would win a championship, then you sell your duck calls, you can show what you can do. But my dad, his claim to fame was, I'm going to build duck calls that sound like ducks, and my judges, the ones I'm going to try to impress, have wings. And so he started building calls, and we built every sound that a duck makes, you know, because the key to duck hunting is to match the sound, here's another revolutionary idea, to the type of duck that you're calling. And then you have the decoys of that duck represented. I mean, duck calling is way down the list of importance as far as being a successful duck hunter. You say, wait a minute. It's like you. If you were saying, well, what do I do to call ducks? You know, I want more ducks on my table. Well, I tell you, I said, look, you need to move, you know, either west or east. Because, you know, Nevada's not exactly a duck haven. People call our company for real. And they said, look, I need a duck call that'll help the ducks finish. Because, look, I'm hunting this field. And every time they get about 200 yards away, they light out there, and I hit them with everything I can. I'm like, look, save your money and move your blind 200 yards. That's where they want to go. So anyway, my dad came out at the hunting world with this kind of idea. And so he built duck calls that sound like ducks. A real mallard hen, she'll do three things. Quack, that's it. She'll do a feeding call. She'll do a greeting call. And that's all she does. And that was the first call that he built, was a mallard hen call. And he built it out of a cedar, piece of cedar for the end piece, and mahogany out of the barrel. Put two reeds in it. Next thing you know, 30 years later, he's on national TV. So there you go.